So if we proclaim Jesus with our mouth,
but we are
filled with impurity, we chase people away from God and we do more damage to the kingdom than non-believers. Actually, we become agents of the devil. And Jesus will say in the end, I never knew you. So remember on judgment day again, Jesus will say to the people on his left, depart from me to the eternal fire that was created for you.
I was hungry,
I was thirsty, you did not give me anything.
I was a stranger,
I was naked, I was sick and in prison, you ignored me. But they would say, Lord, when did we see you in that condition and we didn't
come
to you? He says, as long as you did not do it to this list of my
brethren. That poor man.
That street kid.
You
did not do it to me. So in this age of individualism, greed and selfish ambition
was in our church.
And the dictum of me, myself, and I has become the slogan. So rather than the goodness of God coming out of us, there is a stench of selfishness. So imagine if God is going to say, depart to the place of damnation because you did not feed me.
Because
you did not feed the poor.
How
about if you are even stealing what has been prepared for the poor by others?
It means you are damned ten times over.
The next is, in verse 4, David says, The Lord is my portion and my inheritance. So he says, their sorrows will be multiplied who hasten after another
God.
David is not talking about unbelievers. He is addressing those who are believers, but hasten after another God. Another verse on the New American Standard Bible says, those who have battered for another God. That means they've exchanged the living God for other gods who are not gods. This can be practicing witchcraft on the side. Selfish ambition. You are in Jesus, but money and material possessions are your God.
You worship
power,
even
beauty. David says, I will not worship any of that except the living God. So why should someone who has tested the goodness of God worship another God? The answer is, when you confess Jesus as Lord but do not submit to his Lordship. So when you're in need and you need help from God, you instead trust to meet your need by yourself.
So rather
than first go to supply your financial needs,
go the way of
the world and indulge in a bribery and corruption.
And even
coming up with the water spirit.
You
don't want to faith to use faith, but you want God to be an ATM machine.
Yin permit ni ti kere ni yin yete mirne oba bed bala joga me worde bolo gagi onyo ginora me yin worka borre ka yin timitu chene.
Rather than wait for God to give you a husband or a wife, you engage in fornication.
Akaka koroba me mi yicho onyo dago yin worko wera.
Rather than trust God to pay your school fees, you look for a sugar mommy or sugar daddy.
Akaka koro ni monu ba ina mirchu li school fees chene me worchu kul yin yenyo je morni matoro ti mecho bumirni.
Rather than trust God to fix your marriage, you look for a spare tire, what they call a spare
tire. Akaka nena ni mono peka me di nyumi ni yin eromo yiki chi yin wuri yenyo dong ngatri yako kucha mecho bumirni pieni yot kanu liye.
The Bible says,
Bible company,
Jesus will reject you.
Yesu bidu kweri ko.
You will say, I don't know you.
Okay,
the next one.
Then
David says, the Lord is my inheritance and my cup.
The lions
have fallen for me in pleasant places.
Imagine that you had an
inheritance with your brothers and sisters.
Has
got business.
Gime biashara.
Vehicles, and then you find the will saying, for you, yours is Almighty God.
It means you have
everything you need on earth and in eternity.
Jesus
is the be all and end all in heaven, on earth and under the
earth. In Jesus, we have
everything good and
glorious. That's
why Paul said
in
Ephesians
1:3,
blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ,
who blessed us
with every spiritual blessing
in heaven. Every
means each individual member of a complete set.
Do you know Nuruni Monura Achila Chili Yakira I but Duchamo Bantikere Memi you are?
In this case, every single member of the complete set of blessings in the heavenly realms in Christ Jesus.
In Okwanonaga don't pro weko gumogameti Christo Yesu Ameo Chiki Lobokan Naripolo.
There is no spiritual blessing whatsoever that you haven't yet been blessed with in Jesus Christ.
Peti gumor metu ni Christo Yesu Amanagani yinu put payuku me.
No blessing, no protection, no resource you have an access to in Christ Jesus.
Peti gumoro nyu jamia leo nyu gigimoga bechu memi yuko wara nyima mei Christo Yesu pedo kumi.
No blessings.
Peti gumoro.
No protection.
Guagere mogo.
No mysteries.
Onyu imungogo mei wela malo.
No secrets.
Imungogo.
Except maybe the secret of the day when the Lord will return.
Onyu dunka keken no me kita jiru kubke ni ni ne me duga Christo ngata niope.
You may not have all the gifts.
Because he gives
us different gifts according to his
desire. So that each of us,
we lack something and we need somebody
else. Otherwise,
we'd become arrogant.
That's why Psalm 3
says, bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits.
And I'm going to give you a chela dengum. Kubini monono migum boto banga yini chunya. We pay willi ginorolonga becha no bangomi.
Who pardons our sins? That is salvation.
Amen. Otimu wakisha balwa.
Who pardons our iniquities? That is deliverance.
Who
heals your diseases? That is fixing your physical body.
So who
redeems your life from the pit? That is supernatural restoration.
Who
wounds you with loving kindness?
That brings
healing to our souls. Then finally, satisfies your ears with good things. Other versions say with good food.
And so
that your youth is renewed as the eagles. Okay, let's just jump over to the next, which is the joy of his presence. David said, you will make known to me the path of life. In your presence is fullness of joy. On your right hand, pleasures forevermore. There are two paths available to us as human beings. The path of life and the path of destruction. So, one is a highway that looks very attractive, and the other a narrow path that many prefer not to follow. Proverbs 14:12, there is a way which seems right to a man, but its end is the way of death. Man's way is full of shortcuts. And compromises. That way is guaranteed to lead you to death. Eternal death for sure. Or physical death. Or a limited quality of life on earth. The opposite is a way of knowledge, wisdom, instruction, discernment, understanding, prudence. The way of God's commandments. Read Psalm 119. Read Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 to
8.
The way of life leads to the presence of God. And that's why that song says, turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look into his wonderful face. And the things of this world will grow strangely dim. The light of his glory and grace. So in his presence is fullness of joy. Pleasures forevermore. When Israel came out of Egypt, the Bible says that the sea fled.
Bible teko buni manono namarema teket wekogi.
The hills were running and skipping around. What were they running away from? The presence of God. So when Balak saw this, he thought, let me get Balaam to come and curse these people.
He
said, not be cursed. He could not practice witchcraft from them. Because the
presence
of the king was upon them. And the Bible says it was like the horns of a wild ox.
Bible
the presence of God. Run away. So I want to end here because we have run out of time. And